Hi everyone, my name is Michael Carter, and this is the part two of three of my Camtasia for educators and beginners, and we're going to focus in on how to help students focus on your tutorial videos. So to add additional features to our already existing tutorial, you can use the media bin to add pictures or additional videos on top of the video or to the end of the video that we've already created. We're going to do that by clicking the Import Media button down here. And then search for a video of my son Avery. Once you've got that video inside the media bin, you can either right-click and say add to timeline at the playhead or the needle, or you can just drag the video or picture into the timeline wherever you need it. In our case, we're gonna put it right at the end of the video, and then we're gonna use a trick from the last tutorial. We're gonna split the audio so it's just Avery. And here's what that looks like. What do you think of universal design, Avery? Dr. Cynthia Brame, who has done a lot of research on the effectiveness and engaging elements of tutorial videos, I'll put a link to her website in the link below, suggests that we help learners focus their attention on key elements of a video by using a technique called signaling. This is where you use tools such as zooming, on-screen text and annotations to direct the learner to key information. So to do that in Camtasia, we're going to use the Animations tab to zoom in to a certain part of the screen so that students can focus in on that certain part or something new that they might learn in Microsoft Word. So we're going to click on the Animations tab and make sure that the Zoom and Pan tab is selected. And then we can just pull these little spots in the corner and you see the preview. In the center of the screen is showing where we're going to zoom. And we'll move it over just so it's right in the center of the screen, and that new Picture Tools Format tab is front and center. And you'll notice that there's a little arrow that was created when I started doing that. This arrow, if we run the needle across the tail of the arrow, it's going to start the animation and then slowly move to the spot where you want to focus on. So it looks
This
like this.
format tab, if we
So at the head of the arrow, that's where our final destination or the area we want to focus in on ends. Now, if you want to make this a little bit faster, you can shorten the arrow, or if you want a more deliberate and smoother transition into the point of the screen, you can also lengthen the arrow a little bit. I'll lengthen it to where I start talking again. So now it looks like this on our preview.
format tab, if we click on this.
So sometimes zooming in isn't quite good enough for students if they need more direction. So if this is something new, you might need to add a little bit more of a focus on the Picture Tools Format button. So we'll go right back to where our animation ended, and then we'll add something called annotations or callout buttons to this area. So some of my favorites are you can use simple text, which would just put text on the screen if you wanted some kind of definition. But I'll delete that and we'll save that for a little bit later. And some of my favorite ones are actually in this sketch motion callout. And I usually use a solid square if I'm highlighting a button or something like that in Microsoft Word. So we can add this callout just to highlight that this is the button I'm clicking on because we have to remember that it's very tricky for people to follow your mouse around sometimes. So it's nice to draw attention to the area that we're clicking on. And then this is what that would look like.
We click on this tab, we'll go over to the accessibility.
And then you can see it's a little bit long. So I kind of move on where the needle is right now, but you can see that the call out, the square sketch motion goes on a little bit further. So I can just draw that back a little bit and shorten it because we start moving on to something else. And this is the alt text. So again, maybe we'll add another zoom or we'll pan over to that button a little bit. So we'll go back to the animation tab. I'll click on it. And then I can just scroll over to show that I'm focusing now on the alt text button. And then we should probably add another annotation. And another favorite of mine is the spotlight in the blur and highlight area. So we'll just add a little spotlight, which is gonna kind of blur out the rest of the screen and help students focus on this alt text button. So that just makes it easier to show people what we're clicking on.
This group and click on the alt text icon. This will open up.
So now that we move on from there to a different section of the tutorial, we can shorten that a little bit. And then we want to zoom and pan over to the alt text box. So I'm going to do that. And you might want to just shrink this a little bit to get that to show what we're doing in that alt text pane. So another type of callout that's really useful is to add text to the screen. So you can do that in a few ways, and that's in the annotations tab. And so we're going to add text. My son just started saying, "I like it," but it might not be clear to all viewers what he's saying. So to draw attention to what he's saying, you can use these text callouts. If you use this one, it's just straight text. Or if you want to have like a more cartoony kind of feel to it, if you're doing a fun kind of presentation, you can use this. If you want a more professional presentation, you can just use the text like this. But I'm going to stick with the kind of cartoony looking one just to have some fun and time it. So I'm going to shrink this down. And right at the, I'll zoom in a little bit on the timeline so we can see and kind of match when Avery says, "I like it," which is right here. We want the callout to say the same thing. So I'm just going to start typing, "I like it." And now that looks like this. Although video is a visual tool, clear audio in a tutorial is just as important. I don't have the best microphone, but that's okay. You don't have to have the best or most expensive microphone to add clear audio to the tutorial. I'll show you an audio hack that I discovered in Camtasia about a year ago that helped me improve the sound quality of my videos. So although I'm recording in a relatively quiet room, there is, because I don't have the best quality microphone, there is a little bit of a hum. If you listen to me talking in this part of our tutorial,
exit the alt text pane by clicking on the X.
You can hear a little bit of a hum in the background. So what we're going to do is press the record button, and we're just going to let it run for about 15 to 30 seconds. So now that we've got that in our media bin, I'm going to drag it to the timeline. So this is sort of like a background sound check. And what I'm going to do is put the needle somewhere in here. And then I'm also going to go to the audio effects tab and then bring the noise removal effect down. So I'm just going to click and drag this noise removal effect down. And then in this right pane here, I'm going to say analyze. And it's going to analyze the background noise and remove any additional noise in the background. So what it's already done that to this clip. Now I have to copy the effects and then paste it to anywhere where I might have been recording in the same room. So for these additional places in the tutorial, I'm just gonna press click one, press control on the keyboard to highlight the other three. And then I'm gonna right click and say paste effects. And now when you listen to the audio, it'll be a little bit more clear and the audio will just focus on your voice.
Now we can exit the alt text pane by clicking on the X.
See, much better. So that is it for part two. In the next part, part three of three, we're going to go over captions, sharing, and some YouTube features that can benefit your students. So if you want to join me there, click on this annotation right here, and I hope to see you there. Bye.